of good cheer, of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
The time of the year
is the happiest season of
the year. Hello. My name is Glenn Yetter, and I'll be your child's gifted seminar teacher this year. I'd like to welcome you to Back to School Night. Well, not really. This is what we call a flipped Back to School Night. One of the latest trends in education is the flipped classroom. The idea being that teachers could deliver content, lecture, and information, homework through video or some other type of web content, and then during class, they could actually follow up, drill, practice, check for understanding, make sure students really have the information. So I thought, why not flip a back to school night? As you know, back to school night can be a great, exciting time for parents and teachers to meet. However, time is very, very limited. So through this flipped experience, I hope to give you some enough content information about the class, and then on the actual back to school night, we can spend some time together and you can really get a sense of what it's like to be your child in our class. This video will give you some information about myself, our curriculum, my grading policy, our Moodle site, which is going to be a great resource for you to find out about what's going on in class, and even a little bit about how things actually work on a day-to-day basis in this class. Now, this is not an excuse not to come to Back to School Night, so we still hope to see you there. So let's get started finding out more about Gifted Seminar. The ninth grade Gifted Seminar class will look to answer several essential questions. How do the purposes and functions of a group impact their ability to communicate? For example, a ninth grade field hockey team versus the North Penn School District School Board. What strategies and support materials can you use to present your speech? This will really be explored while we're doing our digital storytelling and other storytelling with and without media. How can we use language to get our communication points across? What influences our ability to communicate, whether it's our message, our target audience, peers, setting, etc.? And some strategies to enhance personal interactive communication, especially nonverbal listening skills, etc.
You make me feel so young. You make me feel so spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I wanna go play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon. You and I are just like a couple of tots.
This is a picture of your child's textbook projects in speech communication. Great resource, lots of activities, web links, etc. This book will be kept in class, so I doubt rarely that you'll see it come home. The topics of study for ninth grade seminar compose of several different ideas. What are some of the fundamentals of communication? The interview process. Last year we were fortunate enough to have Mrs. Cheryl McHugh, the North Penn School District Human Resources Director, come and join us for a few class periods discussing the interview process, proper etiquette, what to wear, questions to expect, etc. It was a great experience and we look forward to doing that again. The ability to tell a good story, like around a campfire or with digital media or without digital media. The ability to host a group discussion, as there is different domains for writing, there are also different types of speeches, whether it's to entertain, inform, or persuade. And finally, the whole preparing and delivering your speech, the practice, the body language, the articulation, etc., will be looked at and discussed as part of this class. In terms of grading for the class, homework, quizzes, and tests or projects will each count as a third towards the final marking period grade. I will have to say, though, one of my goals is to not make this a very high-stress class for your student. So if there is an occasion where the outside interests have a little influence on trying to complete some work, I'm more than happy and willing to work with students. However, I do ask that they make the effort to talk with me prior so we can make arrangements and adjustments as needed.
The login credentials for the Moodle are the same as other North Penn user accounts. Simply the username plus your password. Look under teacher training courses and then Mr. Yetter's gifted seminar. I'd definitely be taking some time with your child to make sure that they can easily log into the Moodle.
So now that we know how to log into the Moodle, let's take a closer look at some of the actual features that we'll be using in class. Moodle has a calendar, gives you upcoming events, we have forums, we have blog entries, we have assignments that can be handed in, we have links to websites, we have PDFs that students can refer to, Word documents, etc. So we'll take a minute or two and take a closer look at some of the features for seminar class. This is an example of a forum that your child will be participating with. This particular one is on leadership, and so I'll post a question for the students to reflect on. They'll respond in the forum, and then the nice part is that students and other students can then go back and respond to their classmates' idea, response, thoughts on the particular subject. It's a nice way for us to create some dialogue. This is an example of an assignment that your child will be handing in via the Moodle. It's a great way for us to have a paperless classroom. The student would create the document on Word, Publisher, create a PDF, download it from a web tool, upload it to the Moodle. I'll have an opportunity to grade it based on criteria we've established, send some comments back with that grade to the students, and then they can see exactly how they did on the assignment. Everything's done electronically, no paper, helps us to clean up the mess and have a green environment, paperless classroom. One of the features I really like about Moodle is the ability to keep track of what students are doing with the Moodle, posts they're looking at, assignments they've uploaded, etc. Complete activity reports on how they're using the Moodle is available at any time. As we talk about digital citizenship, it's really important for students to be aware that what they post online is online for everyone to see. So we talk a lot about the grandmom rule. If you don't want grandmom to see it, don't write it or don't post it. The Moodle activity reports give us an opportunity to reinforce that whole citizenship, digital etiquette in the classroom. So those are just some of the many functions that are available on Moodle. Hope you learned a little bit here, and I really hope you take the opportunity in the next couple weeks to log on with your child. You knew how to log in with the credentials we spoke about earlier, and really get a glimpse in terms of what's going on in class and what the Moodle has to offer for our classroom.
I'd like to invite you to follow our class on Twitter, at Mr. Yetter's Class. Twitter's been great for me professionally in terms of my professional development and making connections around the United States. I also like to use Twitter as another way to help with communication between classroom and school. So please, if you get a chance and you are on Twitter, you can find out more about some of the things we're doing in class. I often tweet out pictures of what's going on, and then sometimes students actually dictate to me, and then we can tweet out some of our learning that takes place. Hope to see you following us on Twitter to stay tuned with what's happening in class.
So that's it. I hope you've enjoyed this flipped experience and finding out some more information about your child's classroom and the seminar class. Please feel free to contact me at any time if you have any comments or questions. And remember, this is not an excuse to not come to back to school night. Hope to see you then. Have a great day.
We'll be right back.